Making the choice to use Deno does not mean that we can't take advantage of the Node.js ecosystem. It also doesn't mean that we have to rebuild all of our Node.js projects from scratch. Using the features of the standard library or the NPM ecosystem is as simple as adding a prefix. If you want to learn more about the Node APIs, you can check out the documentation. Here's an example of using Node's file system module with the promises API. We read the file and we console log the data here. What this would look like in Node is we would just import from fs promises. What this looks like in Deno is we just put the Node prefix here. And then if we run Deno main.ts and we opt into the read access, it's going to read from the file. Updating any imports in our apps to use this Node specifier should enable any code using Node.js built-ins. Deno even supports CommonJS projects, which feels above and beyond. I think that's pretty cool. What if we wanted to use an NPM module from, say, Sentry in our application? We're going to use the NPM colon specifier this time. We'll run Deno main.ts. This is going to ask for access to our home directory and other places. And there we go. We are capturing this error as well. This backwards compatibility is pretty amazing. Are you working on an existing Node.js project? Well, with Deno 2, you can do that too. You can Deno install to install dependencies. You can Deno FMT for formatting. You can Deno lint for linting. We can even run Deno lint --fix to fix some of these problems automatically. And yes, you can also run Deno directly. So for any of the scripts that are part of a package JSON, just run Deno task and the name of the script, like Deno task dev, and this will run that script. We can use all of the code that we've written before without having to change it or stretch it too much. Deno just makes it work.